Hi friends, today is October 21, Sunday, October 21, 2012. This video is on a current issue which deals with the current state of activism. That entire activism is pushed into the direction of opposing corruption, not really solving the problem, but opposing corruption and talking about Janlokpal nonsense. And Arvind Gandhi and Anna both are trying to take attention away from more important problems such as weakening of Indian military, Bangladeshi infiltrators, and increasing influence of multinational companies and poverty. These four problems, I'll repeat: weakening of Indian military, Bangladeshi infiltrator, poverty, and increasing domination of multinational company are more severe than corruption. If corruption is TB, these four problems are cancer that can kill the nation. And what will you get if you have a non-corrupt person like Duratma Gandhi or Jawaharlal Ghazi as Prime Minister of India? For that matter, if we keep beating drums of non-corruption, fine, we must. But that cannot be the only agenda. This Bangladeshi infiltration and weakening of Indian military and rising domination of MNCs over policy making are more important. Poverty are more important, equally important problems, if not more. Let us say that tomorrow, in the name of non-corruption, we make Jawaharlal Ghazi or Duratma Gandhi as Prime Minister of India. These two guys never took any bribe. Of course, Duratma Gandhi used to take money from Bajaj, but it's not possible to label it as corruption. He used to take 100% white money. It's another matter that it is Britishers who had told Bajaj, Sarabhai, Tata and Birla to give money to Duratma Gandhi so that Duratma Gandhi's charkha spinning can go and he can keep all the activists busy. Otherwise, activists would have gone and joined Bhagat Singh or Rashtrapita Mahatma Subhash Chandra Bose and so forth. So, but technically, in all technical sense, Duratma Gandhi is taking money from Britishers via Bajaj, Sarabhai, etc. cannot be labeled as corruption. Similarly, Jawaharlal Ghazi also never took any bribes. His junior could have taken bribe like Pratap Singh Kero and many others, but he himself never took any bribe. So what? He ruined India. Both these great individuals ruined India. So my point is that we should focus on all five problems. Weakening of Indian military, Bangladeshi infiltration, poverty, rising influence of multinational company, Jammu Kashmir problem and corruption problem. We should focus on all six problems. On Jammu Kashmir problem, we have this Bhushan guy who says, let Kashmir become independent. He says this on TV. So what will happen if Kashmir becomes independent? Next day, Kashmir is surrounded by hostile countries like India, China, Pakistan, etc. Russia and former Russian Republic and Afghanistan is also not very far. That Kashmir will ask America to set up base in Kashmir to protect itself from 3, 4, 5 hostile countries. So America will come and set up base. It will take away Kashmir economy in a few weeks. It is very small economy. And then using missionaries, it will convert entire Kashmir into Christianity, which is what America did in Iraq. Some 20% Iraqi population has become Christian, has been forced to become Christian, I would say. And Christianity is also now spreading in Pakistan and Libya. So now Bhushan can say that, okay, he did not take even 1 paisa of bribe, and maybe he did not. All the money is coming by white through donations from Ford Foundation or whatever. So you have a non-corrupt person as a Prime Minister of India like the Arvind Gandhi. He will let all multinational companies come without taking 1 rupee of bribe. He will let all Bangladeshis come. He will give citizenship to all Bangladeshis, not take 1 rupee of bribe. Bhushan can become Home Minister. He can make Kashmir independent without taking 1 rupee of bribe. So you have all non-corrupt people, but they will ruin India. If you do not focus on other five problems which are equally important. So my point is not that you take focus away from corruption problem, but I request all activists to focus on other five equally important problems, namely weakening of Indian military, Bangladeshi infiltration, rising dominance of MNCs, poverty and Jammu Kashmir problem. And at the same time, how you can call end to this game, you question these people. Ask them that we want you to give gazette notification draft to reduce Bangladeshi infiltration problem today. Don't give them 1 minute of time. They have been in this politics business for so many months and years. Bhushan had been law minister in 1977. They call themselves a legal expert. They should have written all this draft by now. And if they have not written, then don't leave them, don't let them leave the room. Give them water, food, whatever they want. Okay, sit in this room, give them a paper, pencil, PC, whatever they want, and say that we want the draft today. Please don't leave the room till the draft is ready. They want consult, okay, call as many people you want to call. If you they want consultation, call, you can talk to them by phone, by video conferencing. You call them in the room, but don't let them leave the room till they give you the draft to reduce Bangladeshi infiltration problem, improve Indian military. Because the fact that they are evading question, and what evading the questions shows that they are serving the foreign agenda. On one of the cases, they did not just evade the question, they made a statement ki bechare Bangladeshi ko anyay nahi hona chahiye. That was the statement made by Arvind Gandhi and Anna. When did they make the statement? That during this August fast, this Bodo and Bangladeshi riot started. So I called up ISC activists that this is an important problem on which you must make a statement. You can't let, they said that our movement is against corruption. So fine, I said your movement is against corruption. But what are you going to do if every Bodo is supposed to leave his house and he has to live in refugee camp and his homes and farms, everything is taken over by Bangladeshi without 1 rupee of bribe? Is that what you want? That you just want to stop corruption but let Bangladeshi take over the land without giving 1 rupee of bribe? So of course they agreed that Bangladeshi problem is important. So they asked Arvind Gandhi to make a statement on it. Arvind Gandhi said, oh, I am fasting, my health is not good, etc, etc. So you can speak on other issues for hours and hours while you are fasting, so might as well speak on this issue for 5 minutes. So finally, when activists forced him to make a statement, I saw this statement on YouTube. I am not able to give, I don't have the link with me right now. He said all this blah 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 that government should protect the Bodo, government must provide proper police protection to Bodo, etc. And then he said, lekin bechare Bangladeshiyon ko bhi anyay nahi hona chahiye. Well, what does this word bechare Bangladeshi mean? The statement I was expecting is Bangladeshiyon ko desh se bahar nikal dena chahiye. Par uske bajaye bechare Bangladeshi talked about work permit and citizenship. What is this nonsense in the same video? So I request all of you to get a statement on this Bangladeshi problem from this Anna and Arvind Gandhi and put that statement on your Facebook status or put it on YouTube or wherever you like. And by doing this, it will become possible to expose that in the name of anti-corruption, they are serving the foreign interest. Why are they not talking about Bangladesh interest? Because there is a channel called as KDTV, MDTV, I forgot its name. That channel is funded on Saudi Arabian money. And they want support of this channel. So they don't want to talk about Bangladesh because Saudi Arabia's dream is to let crores and crores of Bangladeshis come into Northeast so that when the threshold crosses, they can kill the rest of the Indian population and make entire Assam part of Bangladesh, or kill half of them, convert half of them, kidnap the remaining, whatever, which is what they did in Pakistan in 1947 and Bangladesh till recently. So they basically want entire Northeast to become part of Bangladesh, and the weapon they want is let lakhs and crores of Bangladeshis infiltrate into that area and one day they can take over. So the channels which are funded by Saudi Arabia, like MDTV, KDTV, whatever, PDTV, you name it. So if you want, deal is that if you want support of these channels, then you don't talk about Bangladeshi problem. Which is why large number of politicians don't talk about Bangladeshi problem at all. Because they want support of the TV channels which are funded by Saudi Arabia. So my point is that in the name of anti-corruption, by ignoring all this important problem, the nation is losing. And there is not progress on anti-corruption. What is this Lokpal? There is Jindalpal. that today Jindal has to bribe 1,000-2,000 IAS IPS officers across India, maybe more. So get this 11 Jan Lokpal so that Jindal can put two or three of his men as Lokpal, and then remaining 5-6 private, he will hire 2-3 relatives as a lawyer or PR or whatever. And through this 11 Jan Lokpal, he will control all the 5,000 IAS IPS officers which he needs to control to run his coal and iron ore mafia. So basically, concentration of power to support Jindal and Ambani and Mittal or Walmart or Missionary or Saudi Arabia, etc. Basically, this law is MNC Paul or Missionary Paul or Jindal Paul or whatever you call. It is not a solution to corruption problem at all. It is only centralization of power. It will solve, it will reduce the bribe amount that big guys have to pay. But the consolidation of their empire will increase, which in long term will India will lose. And in the name of this corruption problem, they are letting all this, they are asking activists to defocus the important problems such as Bangladeshi infiltration, weakening of Indian military and other problems, Jammu Kashmir problem, etc. So I request you activists to question these leaders on these important issues. Thank you.